It is better that we get the guidance from the creator of everything rather than getting the guidance from the creation themselves. Because once we get the guidance from the creation themselves, then this guidance will be influenced by those who put those guidance. They will not be, such guidance will not be neutral guidance, as if they come from Allah Rabbul Alameen, the one who created everything. My dear respected brothers and sisters, my dear colleagues, what is our duty towards the Quran? What should we do towards the Quran? First of all, we need to believe in the Quran, that it is the exact word of Allah Jalla wa'ala, that Allah Jalla wa'ala revealed for the entire humanity. We need to believe in the Quran. This is the first obligation towards the Quran. The second obligation towards the Quran is we need to read the Quran, my dear respected brothers and sisters. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونثني عليه الخير كله ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله بعثه الله رحمة للعالمين بشيرا ونذيرا فصلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I would like to address all of you with this important topic, how to live the Quran. My dear brothers and sisters, I prefer to discuss this topic on, to address this topic in a very casual way rather than a very academic way. I want the talk about the Quran to come from the heart in order for it to go to your heart, my dear brother, my dear sister, to go to your hearts, my dear brothers, sisters, colleagues. First of all, let us talk about the Quran. What is the Quran? The Quran, my dear respected brothers and sisters, is the speech of Allah Jalla wa'ala, that Allah Jalla wa'ala spoke long time ago. And Allah Jalla wa'ala wrote it long time ago. And Allah Jalla wa'ala kept it in the preserved tablet long time ago. Then Allah Jalla wa'ala sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Then Allah Jalla wa'ala started to reveal to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam the Quran. And the Quran was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam throughout 23 years. The Quran that we have in our hands is the actual and the accurate speech of Allah Jalla wa'ala that He spoke long time ago. No one has touched the Quran. No one has altered anything from the Quran. Jibreel alayhi salam, the angel Jibreel alayhi salam, heard it from Allah Jalla wa'ala. And Jibreel alayhi salam recorded it as he heard it from Allah Jalla wa'ala. Then he revealed it to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam as he heard it from Allah Jalla wa'ala. He did not change anything of the Quran. And Allah Jalla wa'ala took upon himself to preserve this Quran. And Allah Jalla wa'ala honored the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam to preserve the Quran for them without any change, without any alteration. Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. Indeed, we have revealed the dhikr, which is the Quran, and it is upon us to to preserve the Quran. One of the Bani Israel, Yahud people, accepted Islam because of this verse. Long time ago, during the time of Al-Ma'mun, Abbasi Caliphate, he noticed that there is a person who used to be from Bani Israel, from the Yahud, who accepted Islam. He asked him about the reason why he accepted Islam. And this person said that he wanted to test whether the Quran is preserved by Allah Jalla wa Ala or not. So he said that he took a copy of the Quran and he wrote a complete copy of the Quran, and he changed a few things in that copy and he wanted to sell it. People refused to buy it. One after another, they refused to buy it because they realized that it is not the original Quran that Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And then he said, after I have tested this a few times, I realized that this book was preserved by Allah Jalla wa Ala, and I accepted Islam because of that. There is no book, although the Torah is the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala, the Injil is the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala, the Torah is the speech of Allah Jalla wa Ala, the Injil is the speech of Allah Jalla wa Ala, yet Allah Jalla wa Ala did not want to protect them, to save them for the humanity. Allah Jalla wa Ala decided to protect the Quran and only the Quran. That's why the Quran, historically or now, throughout any place, is the same Quran that is read everywhere. Whenever a person makes a mistake in the Quran, then that mistake will be realized by hundreds of people. Why? Because Allah Jalla wa Ala said, "Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun." My dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah Jalla wa Ala honored the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam by revealing this book to them. Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed this speech to them, and he considered this speech as the best of his speech. Allah nazzala ahsan al-hadith kitaban mutashabihan mathaniya taqsha'iru minhu juludu alladhina yakhshawna rabbahum thumma talinu juluduhum wa qulubuhum ila dhikrillah. Allah sent down the best of his speech, ahsan al-hadith kitaban mutashabiha, a consistent book. You don't find any inconsistency in the Quran whatsoever. And not only that, the miracles of the Quran are not limited to the meanings of the Quran, but also to the rhythm of the Quran. When you hear the Quran, you feel that this speech is not the speech of any human being. You will realize that the one who spoke the Quran is someone who is different, is the creator of the universe, Allahu Rabbul Alameen. Allahu nazzal ahsan al-hadith kitaban mutashabiha mathaniya. It is repeated in different ways in the Quran. The story of Musa was repeated number of times in the Quran, and you don't feel bored when you read it in different places in the Quran. The Surah al-Fatiha is repeated thousands of times. Every single Muslim is either repeating Surah Al-Fatiha or listening to Surah Al-Fatiha minimum 17 times a day. And no one, after repeating it hundreds of times, will feel bored of Surah Al-Fatiha. No one would. Have you ever heard someone saying, "Oh, I had enough of Surah Al-Fatiha. I repeated it many times. I don't want to repeat it anymore"? You will never. We have never heard of something like this. كِتَابًا مُتَشَابِهًا مَثَانِي تَقْشَعِرُّ مِنْهُ جُلُودُ الَّذِينَ يَخْشَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ ثُمَّ تَلِينُ جُلُودُهُمْ وَقُلُوبُهُمْ إِلَى ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. The skin of those who submit to the Quran will shiver when they hear the Quran, and their hearts will be softened as well when they hear the Quran. The Quran, my dear respected brothers and sisters, was revealed to the best of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. So it is the best of his speech that was sent to the best of a prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah jalla wa ala revealed the Quran in the best time, which is the month of Ramadan, in Laylatul Qadr. Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr. Indeed, we have revealed the Quran in the night of power. And Allah Jalla wa Ala says, Shahru Ramadan alladhi unzila fihi al-Qur'an. And we all know that the month of Ramadan is the best of months. The month of Ramadan in which the Qur'an was revealed. And Allah Jalla wa Ala chose to send the Qur'an to the best of places, which is Mecca, Umm al-Qura, that Allah Jalla wa Ala called it. Allah Jalla wa Ala honored us, my dear respected brothers and sisters, with this speech. Who are we? We are the Ummah of the Quran. And anyone who wants to join this great Ummah, he is welcome. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed the Quran for the entire humanity. Ya ayyuhan nas, قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بُرْهَانٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَأَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكُمْ نُورًا مُّبِينًا. O mankind, an evidence came to you from your Lord. قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بُرْهَانٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. An evidence, everything in the Quran is an evidence that it came, it was revealed by Allah Jalla wa Ala, it was spoken by Allah Jalla wa Ala. And Allah Jalla wa Ala says, قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ بُرْهَانٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. And we have revealed to you Noor. Allah Jalla wa Ala called the Quran Noor, light. Without the light of the Quran, no one will see any light in his life. Some people might see some light on a temporary basis, but the entire light will not be seen unless the person follows the light of the Quran. And that's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says, Alif Lam Ra. كتاب أنزلناه إليك لتخرج الناس من الظلمات إلى النور بإذن ربهم. This is a book full of blessings. We have sent it to you in order for you to take people from darkness to the light. And Allah Jalla wa Ala also says, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورٍ. If Allah Jalla wa Ala did not give you nur, if Allah the Creator, the Supreme Being, did not give you light, you will never see light. فَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورٍ. He will have no light. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala also said to the entire mankind, Allah Jalla wa Ala sent this Quran to the entire mankind. Those who endorse the Quran will be the people of the Quran, the followers of the Quran. But the Quran is for everyone. Ya ayyuha an-nas, qad ja'atkum maw'izatun min rabbikum wa shifaa'un lima fi as-sudur wa hudan wa rahmatun lil mu'minin. People, not all believers, all people, an admonition and a reminder from your Lord came to you, maw'izatun min rabbikum. And وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ. And it is a healer for all the problems in your hearts. That's why, my dear respected brothers and sisters, those who live away from the Quran will never feel content. They will never feel the inner peace. They will never feel the contentment. They will never feel the real happiness. The real happiness, my dear brothers and sisters, comes through the Quran, and only through the Quran. Many people will challenge this, and they will claim that they are happy because of wealth, because of fame, because of materialistic reasons. They claim this, and I challenge that there is a real happiness away from the happiness of the Quran. And that's why I challenge everyone. I challenge everyone who reads the Quran and understands the Quran, and then he doesn't find that his life will change because of the Quran. I challenge everyone to bring any example of a person who read the Quran, who understood the Quran, who tried to embed the Quran, internalize the Quran in his life, and he doesn't feel a real change. My dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah Jalla wa Ala honored this Quran with so many virtues. One of them, as we said, it is his speech. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala, as the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, whoever reads the Quran, even if he reads one letter, Allah Jalla wa Ala will grant him 10 hasana. And Allah Jalla wa Ala might grant him even more than 10 hasana for reading one letter of the Quran. In the very famous hadith, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi wa Alihi wa Sahbihi wa Sallam said, من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله به عشر حسنات لا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف ولكن ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف. The one who reads a letter from the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala, he will get one hasana, and the hasana will be multiplied by 10. I don't say ألف لام ميم as one letter. I say ألف as one letter, لام as one letter, and ميم is another letter. My dear respected brothers and sisters, when you read just Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, look at this. How many hasana are you going to get? 190 hasana. You are going to get 190 hasana just by saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. On the day of resurrection, every single one of us is in need of just one single hasana, not 100 hasana, not 190 hasana. If you complete the Quran once, you know how many letters are you going to read in the Quran? You are going to read 300,000 plus letters, which means that you will get 3 million letter, 3 million hasana by completing the Quran. If you read the Quran in the month of Ramadan, most likely the hasana will not be given 10 times, will not be multiplied by 10 times, most likely it will be multiplied by 100 times or more than that. So imagine that if you read, if you complete the Quran once in the month of Ramadan, how many millions of hasanat you are going to get. That's why, my dear respected brothers and sisters, we need to be attached to the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. We need to live with the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. And the first step towards the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala is to read it. My dear respected brothers and sisters, part of or among the virtues of the Quran is that Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed this Quran as a guidance. Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed this Quran full of blessings, full of miracles. Everything in the Quran is a miracle. The way it was written, the way it is read, the meanings of the Quran are also, all of them are miracles. Imagine the historical facts that were mentioned in the Quran. How would Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who was illiterate, knew about them? How would Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam knew about many scientific facts mentioned in the Quran? How the human being is created? How is the earth stable by the mountains? How is the rain coming? How is this and that? Many scientific facts are mentioned in the Quran. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam wouldn't know about them except through Allah Jalla wa Ala, the creator of everything. Not only that, but when you listen to the Quran, you feel that this book is not written by anyone. You feel that this book was not said by anyone. You feel that this is a strange book that no human being would even be able to simulate it. And that's why Allah Jalla wa Ala challenged the whole humanity to bring one surah like the Quran. قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ وَأَدْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِّن دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you were denying the Quran, then just bring one surah, just one chapter, that is similar to the Quran. And the entire jinn and ins, قُلْ لَعِنِ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِ وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. They wouldn't be able to produce anything similar to this Quran. My dear respected brothers and sisters, non-Muslims accepted Islam just because of listening to the Quran. When they hear this Quran, they found that this Quran is something different. And then they started to read it and they accepted Islam because of this. Many people accepted the Quran just by reading the first few verses of Surah Al-Baqarah, Alif Lam Mim, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. This is a book in which there is no doubt whatsoever. They ask themselves, who is that person? Who is that human being who can write a book? And he says, this is a book in front of you. You will not find any mistake in it. You will find no doubt in it. I challenge you to find any mistake or any consistency in this book. This is part of the miracles of the Quran. Even part of the miracles of the Quran that you might find in the Quran, words are repeated, verses are repeated. فَبِأَيِّ عَلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ in Surah Al-Rahman, repeated more than 10 times and you hear it. Repeated now and then, and you don't find that it is odd at all. You find letters repeated in one place in the Quran, and you don't find that odd at all. We can give many examples of that. قيل يا نوح اهبط بسلام منا وبركات عليك وعلى أمم ممن معك وأمم سنمتعهم ثم يمسهم منا عذاب أليم. How many times the letter mim was repeated? You find that it is very smooth. It is read in a very smooth way. It is not odd at all, although it was repeated more than 14 times. And this is one of the uniqueness of this book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. My dear respected brothers and sisters, one of the miracles of the Quran, or the main miracle of the Quran, that it is a book of guidance in all aspects of our life. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا. Indeed, that book guides to that what is better in all matters of our life. In all matters, on an individual level, on a societal level, in economy, in politics, in finance, in social life, in every single thing, the Quran is a guidance for the entire humanity. The Quran is a guidance not for the Arabs in Saudi Arabia. The Quran is not guidance for the Muslims. The Quran is guidance for everyone. The Quran is not just guidance for people who lived 1400 years ago. The Quran is still guidance for the humanity now. This is the book of Allah Jalla wa Ala. That Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed it. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ full of blessings. This book that has been revealed to you, full of blessings. مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِي in order for them to reflect upon the Quran. وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ once they reflect upon the Quran, then this will guide them to have admonition, to act upon the Quran and to put it into practice, and that is the ultimate goal of the Quran. My dear respected brothers and sisters, what are the aims of the Quran? What are the aims of the Quran? The Quran was revealed for the entire humanity as guidance in order to what? To bring them out of darkness to the light. What is the light? The light is the light of the Quran when people worship one God, Allah Rabbul Alameen. Without worshiping Allah Jalla wa Ala, people will be worshiping either their own desires, their own whims. They will be worshiping materialistic items in their life. They will be worshipping money. They will be worshipping fame. What is better for you, my dear brother, my dear sister, my dear colleague? To worship a being, a created being like you, or to worship the one who created everything? No one can claim that he is free from worshipping something in his life. It is only Islam that takes people out of being the slaves of beings like them, to be enslaved to Allah Jalla wa Ala, to free them from being enslaved to other created beings, to be free to worship Allah Jalla wa Ala. The real freedom takes place when people worship Allah Jalla wa Ala. They free themselves from everything around them, and they feel the real happiness and contentment, and that is the main message of the Quran. And because Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed the Quran to achieve this message, Allah Jalla wa Ala will be angry of those who reject his message. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says, إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ وَإِنَّ الْفُجَّارَ لَفِي جَحِيمٍ يَصْلَوْنَهَا يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. The righteous people will be in delight, whether in the dunya or in the akhirah. And the fujar, those who reject the truth is what was revealed in this book. What will happen to them? They will be living in Jahim. Jahim, whether in this life or in the hereafter. Jahim refers to all types of hardship, including the punishment of the day of resurrection, including the punishment of the fire of hell. Allah will become angry of those who rejected his message. And this is one of the main aims of the Quran. Again, part of the main aims of the Quran, or one of the main aims of the Quran, is that people conduct their life in this life, conduct their life in a very harmonious way. They will feel the real happiness and tranquility once they implement the guidance of the Quran. The Quran is prohibiting people from cheating, from stealing. The Quran is prohibiting people from drinking alcohol, which is a source of grief for so many of them, or for all who consume alcohol. The Quran is commanding people to be honest, to be merciful to each other. And the Quran is a book of power. The Quran is not talking about these things only. The Quran is talking about how we can conduct our life from a social perspective, from a political perspective. The Quran is talking about the law of war, as the Quran is talking about the law of peace. It is better that we get the guidance from the creator of everything rather than getting the guidance from the creation themselves. Because once we get the guidance from the creation themselves, then this guidance will be influenced by those who put those guidance. Such guidance will not be neutral guidance, as if they come from Allah Rabbul Alameen, the one who created everything. My dear respected brothers and sisters, my dear colleagues, what is our duty towards the Quran? What should we do towards the Quran? First of all, we need to believe in the Quran, that it is the exact word of Allah Jalla wa Ala, that Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed for the entire humanity. We need to believe in the Quran. This is the first obligation towards the Quran. The second obligation towards the Quran is we need to read the Quran, my dear respected brothers and sisters. I have taken a pledge from you last year that you will memorize either one juz or 10 juz of the Quran. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I know that you might say that it is difficult for you to read Quran fluently. But you need to learn how to read Quran fluently. Because once you read the Quran fluently, you will see the impact of the Quran on your life. I always say that shame on every single Muslim who has been Muslim for a number of years and yet he or she is unable to read the Quran fluently. Shame on every single Muslim who is unable to read the Quran fluently, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Allah Jalla wa'ala revealed it, honored us with this Quran, and then we leave the Quran behind our backs. So this is the second thing. We need to learn how to read the Quran fluently. Don't say that you are not an Arab. Allah Jalla wa'ala said, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِن مُدَّكِرٍ We have revealed the Quran easy for those who want to read it, to reflect upon it. Is there anyone who is going to do that? This is what Allah Jalla wa'ala says. The number of people who memorize the Quran from the non-Arabs is far bigger than the number of people who memorize the Quran from the Arabs. Go to Bangladesh, go to Pakistan, go to India, go to many African countries, and you will see millions of people who memorize the Quran. And yet, they do not speak Arabic. So you need to do that, my dear respected brothers and sisters. Most of you are young. You should have a plan to memorize the entire Quran. You will never regret anything in your life as regretting that you did not memorize the Quran on a young age. Wallahi, I testify by Allah that you will never regret something as you regret that you did not memorize the Quran in a young age. Then after reading the Quran, my dear respected brothers and sisters, we need to start to understand the basic meanings of the Quran. Just the basic meanings of the Quran. And that's why I urge all of you to carry a copy of the Quran that has the Arabic, the Quran itself, and the translation in any language you would like, in any language you find it comfortable for you. And you read the Arabic text, and you read the English translation or the Norwegian translation or any translation you like. And you match them in order just to understand the basic meanings of the Quran. My dear respected brothers and sisters, we read, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ Do we know the meanings of اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ Do we know the meanings of this simple verse? Do we always, we read, we hear the Imam reading in Surah, in يوم الجمعة سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى Do we understand those words? Then my dear respected brothers and sisters, after reading the basic meanings of the Quran, let us try to think about those meanings. Live by them. Think about them in every aspect of our life. When you know the entire Quran, you will live by the entire Quran throughout your life. When you wake up in the morning, you will be thinking about the Quran. You will be thinking about certain verses that were mentioned in the Quran. When you face a calamity in your life, you will remember the ayah when Allah Jalla wa'ala says, وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ Take help from the salah and take help by having sabr. When you are facing a situation where you are going to, when you are looking at something haram, you will remember that Allah Jalla wa'ala says, قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ Tell the believers to lower their gaze. And you will also remember, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُنَّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنْ When you are about to deal with a transaction that is full of riba, you will remember what Allah Jalla wa'ala says about riba. When you want to address your brother with a foul language, you will remember that Allah Jalla wa Ala says, قُلْ لِعِبَادِي يَقُولُ الَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَنْزَغُ بَيْنَهُمْ. When you feel frustrated, when you feel that there is no hope for you in this life, you will remember the verse when Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ وَمَا هَذِي الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا لَهْوٌ وَلَعِبٌ. This life is nothing but amusement. It is nothing but a game. You will live by the Quran, my dear respected brothers and sisters. So this is the third reading that you need to have it, which is a reading where you implement the Quran in your life in order to live by the Quran. Moreover, my dear respected brothers and sisters, I urge all of you to have circles whereby you study the Quran. Circles just to study the Quran, to reflect upon the Quran. And don't say that you need scholars. If you don't have scholars, do it yourselves. If you do it as circles, 3 people, 4 people, 5 people, and when you get stuck with someone, then you ask, then you will see that your life is starting to change because of the Quran. Finally, my dear brothers and sisters, I always put this forward for you, that try to read the Quran loudly for 15 minutes every day and check yourself after 1 month what will happen to you. Wallahi, you will see that your life became upside down. Wallahi, you will see this. Just read the Quran for 15 minutes every day. The Quran means the Arabic Quran. Loudly for 1 month, and you will see the impact of the Quran on your life. And you will see that you are tasting a different taste for your life. And then you will understand the real meaning of this life. And then you will be taken from the darkness to the real light, which is the light of the Quran. كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَدَّبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ وَلِيَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ أَلِفْ لَامْ رَا كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ لِتُخْرِجَ النَّاسَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ. Allah Jalla wa'ala says, لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتَهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. Had we revealed this book on a mountain, you will see the mountain humbling itself and cracking because of what? Because of the Quran. And imagine if the Quran was revealed on your heart. I ask Allah Jalla wa'ala to make the Quran as the spring of our hearts, the coolness of our eyes. I ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to help us to learn the Quran and to remember the Quran and to memorize the Quran. I ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to give us shifa in the Quran once we submit to the Quran. I ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to make us the ummah of the Quran, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the best people are the people of the Quran. They are the people of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam.
My question is, we recite Quran every day, mashallah. But most of the time, we do not understand what we are reading. So is there any benefit of reciting Quran every day once you don't know what you're reading? So my question is, mashallah, subhanallah, we all must read Quran. As a matter of fact, we are all Muslims. But number of times, basically myself also, I don't know what I'm reading. So is there any benefit?
Okay. The question is?
Yes.
The question is, if I do not understand the Quran, do I have to read the Quran in Arabic? Is there any benefit? of reading Quran in Arabic or not. First of all, we said that the Prophet said, whoever reads a letter from the Quran will get one hasana, and the hasana will be multiplied by 10. So the first benefit is to get the number of hasanat. My dear respected brothers and sisters, listen to this. The easiest way to get hasanat in this life, to get rewards, to build for yourself houses in Jannah, is by reading Quran. Everything might have some difficulty. Sadaqah, you have to give your money. Fasting, you have to fast. Qiyam al-layl, you have to wake up at night in order to make Qiyam al-layl. But reading Quran, you can have a cup of tea next to you, and you can be sitting, relaxing, and just reading the Quran. That's all. Every single letter will give you 10 hasanat. We know some elderly people who finish the Quran once every 3 days. And this is a message to the elderly people. This is the message for the disabled people. This is a message for the hopeless people. Open the Quran, you will have hope in it. You will have the future in the Quran. If you have no friends, open the Quran, you will have thousands of friends. So, by just reading the Quran, just reading it, even if you do not understand anything of what you read, you will get minimum 10 hasanat for one single letter. Allah Jalla wa Ala, if you read just as we said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, you will get 190 hasanat. If you read Surah Fatiha, you will get 1,300 hasana by just reading Surah Fatiha. This is one thing. The other thing, my dear respected brothers and sisters, the Quran is a miracle, is full of miracles. Once you read the Quran, even if you do not understand it, you will see that your body, your life has been affected positively by the Quran. It is like the sun. When you expose your skin, your body to the sun will affect your body. Vitamin D plus many other vitamins will be built in your body without you feeling that. Same thing will happen to you when you read the Quran. The other thing, my dear brothers and sisters, the Quran, once we read it in Arabic, this will make Arabic easy for us. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala says in the Quran, Inna anzalnahu Qur'anan Arabiya. Allah Jalla wa Ala does not want the Quran to be revealed in any other language. Allah Jalla wa Ala wants to unite the entire humanity on Arabic language. Allah Jalla wa Ala wants this. This is his decision. And this is again one of the miracles of the Quran. Imagine, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that we do not have to read the Quran in Arabic. So, Muslims in Norway, for example, when they read the Quran, when they read the Salah, they read the Salah in Norwegian. They read Surah Fatiha in Norwegian. Imagine a person coming from the Arab world does not know Norwegian at all. He will go to the masjid and he will hear something is being read. Is he going to feel that those people are his own people? Imagine you go to China and you entered one of the mosques there, and there they are reading the Quran in Chinese. Do you feel attached to them? Do you feel that they are your brothers and sisters? But wherever you go, in any part of the world, enter any masjid, and once you go there, you will see the imam, you will hear the imam saying, Allahu Akbar, and then, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. You will feel welcomed. You will feel that this person is your brother. You will feel that this is part of you. You will feel that this is your ummah. This is the globalization of the ummah throughout Arabic language, throughout the Quran. And this is one of the miracles of the Quran. There is no religion like this. That's why whatever they do, the enemies of Islam, they won't like to disunite us. The Quran will unite us. despite any attempt to disunite us. Just the fact that we read one book in Arabic, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْقِلُونَ, this will unite our ummah. This is some of the benefits of reading the Quran in Arabic. And my dear respected brothers and sisters, I urge all of you to learn Arabic. You must learn some Arabic, my dear brothers and sisters, and you are recommended to learn as much Arabic as you can. Because wallahi, once you learn Arabic, you can access Quran directly, life will be different. When you hear the Imam reciting, for example, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا عَنْهَا لَا تُفَتَّحُ لَهُمْ أَبْوَابُ السَّمَاءِ وَلَا يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةِ حَتَّى يَلِجَ الْجَمَلُ فِي سَمِّ الْخِيَاطُ وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُجْرِمِينَ لَهُمْ مِنْ جَهَنَّمَ مِهَادٌ وَمِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ غَوَاشٌ وَكَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الظَّالِمِينَ. For example, if you hear this, you will be amazed of the strong meanings of such words. You will not be amazed if you just listen to it. You will not be so amazed if you just listen to it without understanding the meaning of those words. Okay.
Jazakallah khair, Sheikh. The next question is, a brother or a sister is asking, the thing is that I want to be able to memorize the Quran, but I find it hard to find time. How can I strengthen my willpower so strong that I'm able to memorize it in a short amount of time?
Okay. My dear respected brothers and sisters, this is a very good question. I always say that you need to plan for your life according to the Quran. Make the Quran as the center of your life. Once you plan to memorize the Quran in 5 years, and I think all of you are able to memorize the Quran in 5 years, even in less than that. I knew many young people who memorized the Quran without being in any Muslim country. I know a number of people who memorized the entire Quran while they are in London. In a matter of 4 years, you can do that. If you have a plan over 5 years, then you will have a plan over a year, then you will have a monthly plan, then you have a weekly plan, and then you have a daily plan. If you have a daily plan, whenever you wake up in the morning, my dear respected brothers and sisters, the first thing you will think of, please listen to this, wallahi, the first thing you will be thinking of is when to read your Quran. And once you have that in mind, the first thing you will do after Salatul Fajr is to read your Quran. And this is the best time for you to read Quran. And when you get used to that habit, you will be able to memorize the Quran easily at that time. My dear respected brothers and sisters, there is a language barrier between many of you and the Quran. And that's why I urge all of you to familiarize yourself with the rhythm of the Quran by reading Quran loudly and frequently. I advise you to do the following. Please listen to this. Take short surahs of the Quran. Let us start with surah Qul Huwallahu Ahad. Take that surah and record it in a way that is repeated. And instead of many of you putting those headphones and listening to music, listen to Quran. And I advise you not to listen to the entire Quran, no, plan it, whereby every day or every week you just listen to one surah only, and that is repeated. And once you listen to that, you just repeat with that. For example, you just hear قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ, yeah, the entire surah. بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. Keep listening to it. Keep repeating after it until you are able to match the reciter. We want to stop this. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm Al-Din. We need to stop that. This is not Quran that Allah Jalla wa Ala, this is not the Quran that Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed it. Yes? We need to stop. Kul wallahu ahad, Allahu samad. This is not what Allah Jalla wa Ala revealed. How are you going to learn this? By just listening to it frequently at one time and keep repeating it. Once you know how to read it properly, take the other surah. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ الْفَلَقِ. Once you know that surah as well, take the other surah. And then go throughout juzu amma like this. My dear brothers and sisters, many people tried this and they said that within 6 months, they memorized the last juzu of the Quran and their tongue and their tongues and their ears became very familiar with the Quran, and then they started the journey of memorizing the entire Quran. Please do this, and you will see that it is very, very effective.